Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to take a quick look at a 1970 all-matching Polish AKM. Now these AKMs are affectionately referred to as Kaprals, which actually translates to corporal in Polish, and we're going to take a quick look at it. I hope you enjoy. This rifle is a kit build. It's built on an all-matching Polish AKM kit from 1970, so it still exhibits many of the early features. It has a new Radom Polish AKM barrel. And it's built on a Childers Polish stamping receiver, which unfortunately you cannot get those anymore. So this is a very unique, mostly all Polish AKM. We have a look at the barrel components. Very worn on almost all of the parts. I don't believe that these were shot a whole lot, but it's just very this type of wear is very indicative of a lot of handling wear. And as we come across the lower handguard, you can see the hardwood furniture pieces on the early AKMs before they went to that laminate. And as we come across to the left side of the receiver of the rifle, starting at the rear sight block, you can see some of that original paint runs. Some of that original paint kind of ran there on the top when they painted it. Here we have a look at the rear sight leaf. We have the S marking up to 1,000 meters. And when we flip it over, we do have numbers matching on the bottom of the sight leaf, 13002. A couple of diamond proof marks. As we flip that back closed, we're going to look at everybody's favorite part, the front trunnion. Starting near the barrel pin area, we do have some inspector proof marks. And then we have our Circle 11 Polish factory stamp, 1970, a letter prefix followed by the serial number. As we look at the top cover, we do have a nice diamond proof mark on the lip of the top cover. Coming across the receiver and the top cover, you can see that level of worn away finish. And as we come down, we'll have a look at our very worn pistol grip, but still has some very nice patterns in it, a little contrasty. At the trigger guard, and we're going to take a look at the stock. As we look at the dust cover from the rear, we do have the serial number stamped into it on the back side, and a look at the rear trunnion from the outside along with the top of the stock and the very worn out, almost completely stripped butt plate. Here we have a look at the rifle from the other side. It's important to note that 1970 is one of the last years that they still had the three spot wells above the magazine well dimple. It later went to the standard II Soviet style, along with almost every other Euro style AKM of that era. Here we have the C and the P Polish selector markings. And an overall look at the patina from the right side. We have a look at the gas tube takedown lever and rear sight block from the right side. That same level of wear along the gas tube and lower handguard. And as we come across the barrel to the gas block, it is a standard milled style gas block. It does have the later style milled out lightning cut right here. And as we look at the front sight block, this is still old style Soviet. In terms of the front sight block on the rear having no lightning cut, it's completely flat on the rear, and we'll try to take a look at it. We do have a nice proof mark back there. And then a look at the front with the muzzle nut. Just a very generic 1960 style AKM. Here we've popped the dust cover, and you can see on the left side of the bolt carrier, we do have the serial number stamped into it. And as we come across to the recoil rod, we do have the serial number also stamped into it. And as we look inside at the rear trunnion, it is still the old style donut hole rear trunnion. And as far as I know, the Polish maintain this standard all the way throughout their AKM production. I'm not sure if they continue that into the 90s or they changed to a fork trunnion. If anybody knows, let me know, I'd be interested. And of course, the selector there on the left side of the screen does have the last three digits, 002, of the serial number. on the top of the trunnion, we do have the forging code, which appears to be a 25. And then some other stamps. Here's a look at the field strip 1970 Polish AKM. Let's take a closer look. First, starting with the gas tube, we do again have the serial number stamped into the bottom of it. Look at those spot welds along the sleeve of the gas tube on the front and the rear. And we'll take a look at our bolt. It's a pretty well-used bolt, not super severe, but you see that nice carbon ring around the inner part of it. And again, we have our serial number on the side of it. And as we look at the number again on the left-hand side, we do have the double cluster of diamond proofs along with some numbers stamped on the inside of the carrier. As stated before, it is a new production Polish Radom barrel, so there really are not any markings on it that would be on a military Polish AKM. However, you can just see how nice that barrel is as we come across on the inside to the outside. Here we have a look at the lower handguard retainer. And that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick look at a Polish AKM. These are pretty boring AKs compared to some of their counterparts from the same era. So I hope you garnered some new knowledge or wisdom or a desire to build or not build one of these. Either way, thanks for watching.